Saint Bernadette Catholic Church. We are glad you're here, and to all who are visiting or returning, we extend a special welcome. We are not complete without each and every one of you. As we begin Mass, let us pause a moment and offer one another a gesture of welcome. Today, we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. The Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Roland Lopez. Father Don is presiding. Today's second collection is for Catholic University. As a reminder, the second collection will follow right after the first collection and ease the basket with the green lining. We are grateful for your generosity. We invite you to sing using the liturgy sheet that you are welcome to pick up at the doors of the church. Please return them to the baskets following Mass. Our opening song is, "O Breathe on Me, O Breath of God." Please stand.
Let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call all sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication. With divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert, and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Praise the
A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, sit here, please, while you say to the poor one, stand there or sit at my feet. Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my brothers and sisters, did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of the Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spitting, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, Ephphatha, that is, be opened. And immediately the man's ears were opened. His speech impediment was removed and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished and they said, he has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak. The Gospel of the Lord. This past Wednesday, we observed once again, at Pope Francis's request, the World Day of Prayer for the Care of Creation, and began what Pope Francis has inaugurated as the Season of Creation, which continues until the Feast of St. Francis of Assisi on October 4th. Pope Francis' communication on Wednesday outlined our responsibilities in relationship with nature, and as never before has called on all countries to appeal, especially industrialized countries, for a common commitment to stop the indiscriminate abuse of our planet's resources. Sadly, like so many issues today, the truth of climate change is held hostage as intellectual property claimed by partisan politics. Pope Francis, with his encyclical given 6 years ago, Laudato Si, pleads for us to recognize the signs of the times and see the alarmingly increasing environmental disasters, floods, storms, fires, the disappearance of indigenous populations and species of plants and animals, and the famine and economic collapse of poorer nations. He pleads for us to see these not as intellectual property, but as reality, reality which represents a desperate need for action. Pope Francis in Laudato Si expressed the hope for an alliance between humans and the environment after the example of St. Francis of Assisi. The concept of integral ecology, as it is now known everywhere, acknowledges that whatever is happening, whether epidemic or climate change, every aspect of life has relevance, social and economic, moral and political. He addresses everything that affects the lives of the poorest and the most fragile, and appeals to a collective and solid commitment to take responsibility for a culture of care that keeps human dignity and the common good at its center. A culture of care that guards and promotes justice, equity, security, and environment as central priorities. Faithful to the Judeo-Christian tradition, the Pope celebrates the creation of the human person as the highlight of creation. But the dominion over creation given to us by the Creator is not a license for exploitation, rather a call to responsibility. The goods of creation are meant to be shared with everyone, not merely those who have greater technology or military strength. On the occasion of this anniversary this week, a virtual summit on climate took place on the initiative of the United States with 40 world leaders to begin preparations for the 2021 United Nations Climate Change Conference in Glasgow, Scotland, November 1 through 12. Pope Francis has committed to ensuring that the Vatican City-State reaches zero net emissions before 2050, intensifying environmental management efforts which have already been underway for a few years, which will provide water and energy, efficiency and sustainability. In his vision, nations help less fortunate nations to accomplish these goals. We don't have to search far in the gospel for the foundation of these values. Pope Francis' teaching on creation leads us to healing. I don't know, I'm sure you remember his prayer before the Blessed Sacrament in an empty, rainy St. Peter's Square on March 27, 2020, at the height of the pandemic. Perhaps you remember vividly. He prayed, "God, in this world that you love more than we do, we have gone ahead at breakneck speed, feeling powerful and able to do anything. Greedy for profit, we let ourselves get caught up in things and lured away by haste. We did not stop at your reproach to us. We were not shaken awake by wars or injustice across the world, nor did we listen to the cry of the poor or of our ailing planet. We carried on regardless, thinking we would stay healthy in a world that was sick." Of course, throughout his pontificate, Pope Francis has been pointing us towards the people on the margins and trying to awaken our Christian compassion to overcome indifference to their suffering. He has warned us against an over-dependence on electronics and technology to the exclusion of genuine human encounters. He has invited us to take the invitation to holiness and sainthood seriously, and he has challenged us to become engaged in a mission we have received from the risen Christ, rather than wait for someone else to build up God's kingdom. Well, how can we, is it up to us to build up God's kingdom? How can that be, especially now that we, the most powerful nation in the world, are so aware of our uncomfortableness of our own vulnerability at a time of pandemic? Always go back to the scriptures. Listen to these words in today's context. Thus says the Lord, "Say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication. With divine recompense, he comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. The lame will leap like a stag, and the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground, springs of water. One can't listen to these words today without thinking about the pandemic, the drought, the famine, the burning forests and towns, and the flooding rivers. As well as the Lord's justice, which opens the eyes of the unjust and gives people on the margins a voice. He will restore the proper order of his creation. And now listen to the gospel. The same impediment of speech and deafness is approached by Jesus. All were exceedingly astonished as they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." Their faith brought the deaf man to him, and they begged Jesus to lay his hand on him. It is true we must do all we can to build up this kingdom of God, the new creation which is to be transformed by God into the fullness of his life. It is his gift to us, not as a possession, but placed in our stewardship, our care. But we are confronted with so many barriers, infirmities, and our own powerlessness. So we must turn to the Lord as well and beg him to lay his hand on this earth, so troubled. His power of healing is the power we need, and the source of our healing, which must go to work in our own hearts and convert us first. Was it St. Augustine who first said we must pray like everything depends on God and work like everything depends on us? The sixth anniversary of Laudato Si is a reminder that the clock is ticking. If we have done little with this encyclical, and if we have done little to examine our own lifestyles, and if we have done little to advocate for a change in policies or to act for the promotion of good policies and pacts, may our recent experiences of vulnerability and the teachings of our faith prod us into action now. May we be about the healing of our suffering world as we also regain our health. Now let us stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Seeking to rely more fully on God, the giver of all that is good, let us offer our prayers to him for our needs and the needs of all God's children.
For our elected officials, especially those responsible for making laws, that they will be attentive to the voice of the Holy Spirit, to remember the need to care for all his people, especially those in distress or at risk, or with no one to defend them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from storms, fires, and floods, who have lost loved ones, homes, or jobs, for generous hearts to respond to such a great need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for a deep awareness of the call that God has given to every one of us to be faithful and serve Him and one another with all our hearts and all our gifts, particularly that God help us know our responsibility to help each other carry life's daily crosses. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those whom God is calling now to priesthood and religious life, that they may realize the beauty of God's call and the potential gift they are for God's people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing our sick and for praise, peace, and eternal life for all who have died, especially the benefactors of St. Bernadette, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear our prayers and answer them according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God, for you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of your Lord, draw.
youth output. Draw near and take the body of the Lord, and drink with faith the blood for you output. Saved by Christ's body and his holy blood, with souls refreshed we give our thanks to God. Eternal Son has by his cross and blood the victory won. He spent his life for greatest and for least. Praise Christ the Paschal victim, Christ the priest. And claim the promise of salvation here. Christ ruled our hearts and all his sins defends. He gave believers life that never ends. Draw near, take the body of your Lord. Draw
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever. So unless they've come since Mass started, we got a notice that our bulletin shipped from Pennsylvania on Wednesday morning, but they never got here. So I don't know if they got washed off the road or whatever in a flood, but we apologize, there's no bulletin, but it is online. You can always find it on our parish website. The second collection next weekend is for our religious education program. We thank you for your generosity. We welcome all who might be discerning baptism or profession of if you or someone you know are seeking answers and might be thinking about joining the Catholic Church, please contact us at the office to register. The rite of Christian initiation for adults begins Monday, September 13. There are several changes to this month's youth ministry calendar and confirmation retreat dates. Please see today's bulletin announcements for more information. We are still in need of volunteers for religious education classes this fall. Catechists and aides are needed for both Sunday afternoon and Monday evening sessions. Training materials and support is provided. Please contact Lynn Jones at the parish office for details. We will formally take up a second collection the weekend of September 26 to provide support to those impacted by the earthquake in Haiti on August 14. If you would like to provide financial assistance in advance of that collection, please make checks payable to the Catholic Diocese of Arlington, Catholic Charities, with Haiti earthquake disaster in the memo line. Based on updated guidance released by the Centers for Disease Control, we recommend still that everyone, including individuals fully vaccinated, wear a mask in public indoor settings. And finally, our parish offices will be closed on Monday in observance of the federal holiday. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Need.